I'm doing a study to select strains that work in the different districts and agroecological regions of Zimbabwe.
So what she's doing is to try and look at the bank of rhizobium strains and see if there are any other indigenous strains that we have or exotic strains that we have there that can perform better than the commercial strain. Imagine if this, we have something already that is better than what we are selling to the farmers already, that it would also work better in improving biological nitrogen fixation.
There's also work that has been done with the Soil Productivity Research Laboratory, also known as the Grasslands Research. So they've also collected a large number of nodules from a larger variety of soils, and they've isolated, and I'm sure they've also characterized and tested them in the greenhouse.
Predominantly we have granitic sands, and this is not very good for our legume production. And the fertilizers that we have now, they do not contain those macronutrients that are absent in the soil that are needed for legume production. You know, we have soils, when you apply a fertilizer, when you inoculate, still you see a response, yes, but it doesn't pass a certain level. The yields remain very, very low. So in the end, they are called the non-responsive soils. Already we can see maybe there are two or more strains that are performing better than the commercial strain.
Okay, the major producer in Zimbabwe produces only specific soybean varieties. From earlier research, the Inter-Africa Project, the agronomy trials, we found out that promiscuous varieties are actually doing very well in terms of biomass, in terms of yield. So I think also engaging breeders, get new improved varieties to match with the poor soil conditions in the smallholder areas.
As an agronomist, we look at soybean as, in fact, all legumes as nitrogen fixers and improving soil fertility. But the easiest way to make farmers grow is to have a market on the other end.